when I was, you know, traveling in helicopters from the likes of, Nice to Monte Carlo, staying in five-star hotels like the Hermitage Hotel and having a fantastic time and all that kind of stuff, I realized that every single time I got big deals in or, you know, met amazing people, it didn't really truly make me happy. And I realized that I kept thinking that when I get this, I might be happy. And then when I get that, I might be happy. And when I got there, I wasn't any happier. And what I truly realized that when I started giving to others and when I started helping and supporting others in terms of connecting from this head self to this heart self and connecting with your true passion, purpose, and meaning in life, and then seeing that and helping them on that journey as well, because I had done it myself, then I realized that was the key to life. And that was the key, what I wanted to try and do and implement in my lifetime as well. And I found that key change point for me was probably the near-death experience, where I was lying on one of those hospital moving beds, suddenly surrounded by this amazing feeling of love, energy, and connection, this light as such. And I realized I was having a near-death experience. If you take your best orgasm and times it by about 100, you might just get the feeling all around your body. So at that point, I realized, obviously I came back, otherwise I wouldn't be speaking to you now, that I needed to change my life in some way or form. And it took time because the ego was still in the way. But gradually, I was pushed that way through universal consciousness in some way or form. And eventually, here I am now.
Right. So coming back to the question about other people, so the people that you've engaged with to try and understand what makes them successful, have you identified a golden thread for those people that tends to be a common factor that generates that success?
100%. It's having about a love for what you do, a love for the people you work with, and a love for the people you serve as well. I always say love is an acronym for lots of vibrant energy. So it's really finding that passion, that sense of purpose and everything like that. People talk about all different ways that you get your energy levels up to the highest level. But actually, if you have that sense of purpose, passion, and you find what that truly is, what your true meaning in life is, and then you go out there and do it every single day, it gives you an exponential amount of energy in terms of what you do. And you tend to spring out of bed rather than having to drag yourself out of bed to do what you're meant to do. So that was what it is. And you can find that in many different ways. Like, you know, I always say, write down what you truly love doing, write down what you're gifted at doing, and write down what you can add value to people in some way or form, work out a match between those three, and you're probably on a good thread towards what your purpose is. Or have a look at all the shit that's happened in your life and turn your mess into a message and give it meaning to help other people in some way or form. Otherwise, why did it happen to you? One of my clients was blown up in the Brussels bombing. And she lost, you know, she was almost on the brink of Olympic swimming. And she lost the ability to be able to compete at that level afterwards because she lost her stomach and many other things. But then we reframed her mindset and turned her mess into a message to give it meaning, or her tragedy into a triumph to help other people in some way or form. And it gave her a new sense of vitality. And the other thing is, right, Jeff, I've spoken on many stages in front of, say, for example, 4,500 people. So if I was to get you a stage in front of 4,500 people, you're 85 years of age, and I said to you, what would you speak about most? What would you be the most passionate about? What would the message or legacy you'd like to leave? And then once you know what that is, then reverse engineer yourself back to where you are today and work out, what do I need to do? What do I need to learn? Who do I need to work with? Who do I need to collaborate with to be worthy enough to stand on that stage, deliver that message, and leave that legacy for people?
I do something very, very similar where I say, right, you're on your deathbed, you're 91 years old, you've got 24 hours left to live. So I want you to play back to me now all the things that you think people think of you. Tell me what you think the world thinks of you, your family, your friends, your colleagues. And they'd say, well, they probably think I was a tight sod. They probably thought I was a miserable git. They probably thought that I had a short fuse. They probably thought, and it goes on. So I then said, so now tell me what you would like people to think about you, how you would like people to speak about you. I'd love them to say I was kind, I was generous, I was giving, that I help people, that I always put them before myself, and so on and so on. So he says, so you can see there's a gap between how you think people feel and what you'd like them to feel. And the answer is yes. Well, I've got some good news for you. You're not going to die in 24 hours. What are you now going to do to create the outcomes that you've now said are important to you when you still have the chance? And that's when you get people to really think about that self-reflection, that ability to put the mirror up and say, do I really like who I am or who I've become? And you've got a choice, right? You've now given yourself a choice, which on your deathbed at 91 with 24 hours to live, you're out of time.
I love that. And what that is all about there is the motivation. It's about that reason in order to create that change in your life. And sometimes you need that, and it can either be pain or pleasure to create that as well. But the other thing I would say is also that motivation comes from the word motive, which is a reason which is outside you. And basically what you've just said there is also basing it slightly on what other people think about you. And the most important thing is what you think about your own self, to be able to connect with you, with your heart, with your real self, and not really care about other people. And that comes from inspiration rather than motivation. Because inspiration comes from the word in spirit, which means it comes from inside of you and a place of love. And when you connect to your true self, your higher self, your best self, your soul self, you don't really care about what other people think, because you're on that mission, you're on that place of love, you're coming from that heart space, and you know, regardless, it doesn't matter what other people think of you, because you're going to be motivated, but more so inspired to create that mission in life.
So if I say to you, and you can only say two things, what are the two reasons we exist as human beings on this planet?
So number one, I think as a spiritual being having a physical existence on this planet, we should enjoy life in terms of the five senses. So the gift of being able to see the sun, the sea, the stars, the sky, and appreciate that with gratitude, because there are people out there that I actually know who cannot see. Also as well, the gift of being able to hear the whistle of the wind, a river running by, or the sea lapping up on that beach, because there are people that we know that can't hear as well. Also, yeah, to be able to have the touch in terms of a kiss, hug, or something like that. And also be able to taste, even like COVID, people haven't been able to taste the likes of chocolate and the things that we love. So to enjoy the five senses in life, to be able to have gratitude for the small things in life, allows and opens up your subconscious mind to enjoy more of life. So that's number one. And number two is obviously is to first find out what you truly are here for life. And that comes down again, like I said, in terms of what are you gifted at doing? What has God or the universe or even your own self gifted you in this lifetime to be able to do and help other people? And what gift can you bring to the world to add value to up people's consciousness throughout this planet in some way or form?